So for this unit, it's going to be similar to last unit. Last unit, we're working with area in two dimensions. So this unit, we're going to be working with volume in three dimensions. So we're actually still going to need our formulas from last time. So for a rectangle or a parallelogram, the area is equal to base times height. And then for our triangle here, this face over here will be our base, so half the base times height. And then lastly, for our cylinder, we still need to understand and know the area of a circle as well as the circumference of a circle. So all of these formulas are going to help us out when we're doing volume. So let's go ahead and get started. Here's the first form you might see, the volume of a square prism. So not all square prisms are cubes. So as you can see, we have a square prism here that is a cube. It's 10 length, 10 width, and 10 height. But over here, you could say 10 length, 10 width, but 18 height. So this one is not a cube, but it's still called a square prism. So here's how we'll go ahead and start to think about it. Step one is to write the correct formula. So of course, the formula we need here is volume equals base times height. So the thing that we want to keep in mind is that the base is going to be what's here in this purple. So our base shape for a square prism is that square. So we're going to first have to actually calculate the area of that square and then plug that into the base. So area is equal to base times height. In this case, it's going to be 10 multiplied by 10, which is going to give us a value of 100 centimeters squared. Now that's the area, centimeters squared. Now, all we're going to do is plug that base into this, which is going to be 100, and then our height in this case will be 10. So our base times our height will give us a value of 1,000 centimeters cubed. It's cubed now since we're dealing with volume and 1, 2, 3 dimensions. Now, let's do the same over here. Our formula that we're going to need is capital B base times height. So of course, once again, the base is the area of the base. So area is equal to base times height here. So once again, it's the same thing. 10 multiplied by 10 is going to give us 100. So we have 100 centimeters squared. So we have 100. This time, our height is going to be equal to 18. So 100 multiplied by 18. So our total value is going to be 1,800 centimeters cubed. Okay? So let's go ahead and try this for all of our other prisms and our cylinder. So for our next prism, we have a rectangular prism. So once again, the volume of a rectangular prism is equal to the base times height. But in order to figure out the base, we have to figure out the area of that base. So area is equal to base times height from our previous knowledge. So our base in this case is going to be 7.5 here for our bottom. And then our height is going to be equal to 4. Okay? You could also, if base times height is confusing you, just think about this as length times width. Okay? So 7.5 multiplied by 4, I don't need parentheses, this is going to give us a value of 30 inches squared. So that is the base, 30 inches squared. So now we have to take that 30 inches squared and multiply it by 2.5. So 30 multiplied by 2.5 is going to give us a value of 75 inches. Inches cubed. All right, so this would be the answer for the volume of this rectangular prism. Let's try a second example. Once again, volume is equal to base times height. All these formulas are going to be the same. The only thing that we're going to be calculating differently is this base layer right here. So base times height, or in other words, length times width, we have 6 multiplied by 3, which will give us a value of 18 centimeters squared. So that's our area. So the area of the base, 18, is going to be multiplied by our height, which is 4. So 18 multiplied by 4 is going to give us a value of 72 centimeters cubed. All right? Feel free to pause the video anytime if you have to go back to this, but it's pretty basic. We're just finding the area of the base, basically, and then multiplying it by the height. I urge you, write the formula down. It's because when we get to problem solving the day after tomorrow, it's going to be very, very hard to understand what's going on if you're not writing down the formula. Okay, next. Let's go ahead and get a little bit more complicated now. We're going to talk about the triangular prism. So This is a right triangle. Whenever you see a right triangle with this indication here, the height is not in the middle over here. The height is actually 5, and our base is going to be 4.5. Okay? So remember, when you see that right triangle, it's just these two lengths. So let's go ahead and get started. Volume is equal to capital B times the height. So our area is going to be equal to half base times height, or base times height divided by 2, whichever way you want to think about it. All right? So now, half of 4.5, and then we're going to multiply this by our height. So our height in this case is going to be equal to 5. There we go, equal to 5. Now, I could take 4.5 and multiply it by 5 and get a value of 22.5. But then, after I get 22.5, I have to take half of that. So 22.5 divided by 2 is going to give me a value of 11.25 centimeters squared. Now, I'm going to take that 11.25 and then I'm going to multiply it by the height. In this case, our height is going to be equal to 8. So when I go ahead and multiply by 8, I get a value of 90 centimeters squared. All right? So this is going to give us an area of 90 centimeters squared. Okay? Next, same thing, except this is not a right triangle. This is an isosceles triangle, so the height is actually right here in the middle. So volume is equal to capital B times H, base times height. Area is equal to half the base times height. So we have half of the base, which is 8, multiplied by our height, which is 3. I'm just going to go ahead and take half of 8. Half of 8 is 4. So 4 multiplied by 3 is going to give me a value of 12. So we have 12 centimeters squared. And this should actually be centimeters cubed over here, not squared. So our base is going to be 12 multiplied by our height, which is also going to be 12. So 12 times 12 is going to give us a value of 144 centimeters cubed. Okay, and that's pretty much it for triangles. You just have to remember that triangle formula, half the base times the height, and that'll be our base value of here, and then all we're doing is pulling it back to get the height. So once again, the base value is here, and we're multiplying it by our height. Let's look at our last example, which is most likely going to be our most complicated one, especially when we're problem solving in the next 2 days. So make sure to pay very, very close attention here. So volume is equal to, once again, base times height. It's the same for all of them. The only thing that's different are our areas. So our area is going to be equal to pi r squared. We're going to solve this a little bit differently, which I think will help your math out. We're not going to evaluate pi until the very, very end. You'll see how helpful that would be. So r squared is going to be 4 squared. I'm just going to put a constant in front of pi. It'll make it easier to work with. So 4 times 4 is 16, so we have 16 pi inches squared. That is our area. Let's just keep it as pi for now. After we multiply 16 by the height, we'll change that pi to 3.14. So our base is 16 pi. Our height in this case is going to be 10. Now, I'm just going to multiply 16 times 10. I could do that. That's a mathematical property. That's okay. 16 times 10 is 160, and we still have pi. All right, technically here, we're multiplying three numbers. That's why I'm able to do that. 16 is a number, pi is a number, and 10 is a number. So I can multiply 16 times 10 first, and then I can multiply by pi at the end. So now that's going to be 160 multiplied by 3.14, which is going to give me a value of 502.4 inches cubed. Okay, so I highly recommend save pi until the very end to convert, so you'll have less math to do. Next, let's just try two more. Volume is equal to base times height, so area is equal to pi r squared. So once again, I'm just going to put the r squared term in the front, so 8 squared. Keep in mind that's 8 times 8, not 8 times 2. So 8 squared is going to be equal to 64 pi, which is going to be equal to, well, actually, yeah, 64 pi centimeters squared. Now our base is going to be 64 pi multiplied by our height, which in this case is 15. Now let's take 64 and multiply it by 15. We get a value of 960 pi. 64 times 15 is 960. Now, 960 multiplied by 3.14 is going to give us a value of 3,014.4 inches cubed. Okay? All right. So, once again, find the area of the circle and then simply just multiply by the height. That's how all of these prisms and cylinders are going to work. For the pyramids and everything else, we're going to try something different, but we'll just focus on the prisms and the cylinder for now. So next, volume is once again equal to the base times height. Always start with your formula. Area is equal to pi r squared. In this case, it gives me the diameter as opposed to the radius in the previous two examples. So the diameter is twice the radius. So in order to find the radius, I just take the diameter and divide by 2. So it's going to be 5 and then squared because it's r squared. So 5 squared pi is going to be equal to 25 pi feet squared. So that is my area. Now, my base is once again 25 pi multiplied by my height, which is going to be 21. I'm just going to go ahead and multiply 25 times 21 and get a value of 525 pi. And then I could just simply multiply 525 by 3.14 at this point. And I'm going to be left with a value of 1,648.5 inches cubed. And that would be my answer for the volume of the third cylinder. So as you can see, it's not hard. It's just building upon our prior knowledge. But once again, just like last unit, you need to know how to multiply. You need to know how to multiply fast and efficiently. And if you're just writing down your formula, it'll help keep you organized. Okay? That's it for